गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सोल्व अवर एक्सरसाइज 7.3। ओके, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिड इट्स बेसिक्स, सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग दिस। आवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज गिवन that how many three digit numbers can be formed using digits 1 to 9 if no digit is repeated. Okay, so what they are given is, it is the first question that we have to make three digit numbers. Okay, and second, digits are given to us 1 to 9. Okay, third thing, that no repetition should be there. So the required number of permutations will be what? It will be equal to 9 3. Total 9 are there and we are taking 3 at one time. So this will be 9 factorial divided by 9 factorial minus 3 factorial means 6 factorial. So it will be 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 factorial by 6 factorial. So it is what? It is equal to 504. Okay, so next is, how many 4 digit numbers are there with no digits repeated? Okay, so 4 digit numbers with no digit, no digit repeated. So I will find it. This we will find by taking 10P4. Total 10 digits are there. Out of which 4 we can take at one time. But it is also possible that in this way we get a 0 in first place, which we do not need. Okay, so that will reduce and this will be what? So here we can use 9 digits. Okay, and from the remaining 9 we will take 3. Okay, so it will be 9 into 9 factor 9p3. So it will be 9 into 504. Hence you can get your answer. Okay, it was one basic that we do not require the 0 at our thousands place. Okay, other everything is as it is. Now, how many 3-digit even numbers can be made using the digits this if no digit is repeated? Okay, so third question is given to us. 1, 2, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay. These digits are given to us and we have to make 3-digit even numbers. 3 digit even numbers means what? We get a 2, a 4 or a 6 at ones place and any other here too. Any we can get. So that means what? Required numbers will be equal to what? 3 at ones place. Okay. any of the three we can keep here. And the remaining six, okay, which one we have keep here? Remaining six, from these six, we will need only two of them. So 6p2. So it will be 3 into 6p2. This will be 3 into 6p2 means what? 6 factorial divided by 4 factorial. So this is 3 into 6 into 5. So it will be 19. Okay. 6 factorial we write as, we can write as 6 into 5 into 4 factorial. 4 factorial cancels 4 factorial. And we get our answer. Okay. This. So in this way, question can be solved. Now, similarly fourth. Okay. Now in the fifth one. What is our fifth question? Our fifth is given that from a committee of 8 persons, in how many ways we can choose a chairman and a vice chairman, assuming one person cannot hold more than one position. So that means what? Total 8 are there. From that we need 2. One as chairman and another as vice chairman. Okay, so I will take required number of permutations will be equal to what? It will be 8p2. So this will be 8 into 7 into 6 factorial divided by 6 factorial. This will cancel it and we will get 56. So in it means in 56 ways we can select our chairman and vice chairman. Okay. Now in question number 6, what we have to do? We are given n-1p3 ratio with np4 equal to 1:9. Okay, so this thing is given and we have to find the value of n. So this we can write as n-1p3 by np4 equal to 1/9. This will be 9 into n-1 factorial divided by n-1-3 factorial. This will be equal to n factorial divided by n-4 factorial. So this will be 9 into n-1 factorial divided by n-4 factorial. So this, now I can write n as n into n-1 factorial divided by n-4 factorial. n-4 cancel n-4. n-1 factorial cancels this. So what do we get? We get that value of n is 9. Okay, so in this way you can solve this question. Okay, similarly in 7th question 2 parts are given. In that we have to find the value of r. In the similar way we can find it. Okay, now the question number 8. How many words with or without meaning can be formed using all the letters of word equation, using each letter exactly once? So in question number 8 we are given a word equation. Okay, all the letters are different. And what they are asking is, how many words can be formed from this? And each we have to use only once. So this means what? This will be equal to how many letters are there? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 3, 6, and 8. Total 8 letters are there. So that means what? Total number of words will be equal to what? It will be equal to 8 factorial. 8 factorial means what? It will be equal to 40,320. So these many can be formed with or without meaning total number of words. Okay, so next will be, what is our next question? It is given that word Monday. Okay, the word Monday we have to use, and we have to make words with or without meaning taking 4 at a time. Okay, so that means what? It is our question number 9. It is given to us the word Monday. First part is what? 4 letters at a time. So required number of words equal to total number of words 6, p taking at a time 4, so it will be 6p4. So that means we 6 factorial by 2 factorial. So this will be 6 into 5 into 4 into 3. So this will be 360. So total 360 words can be formed. Okay. Then second it is, all letters are used at one time. For all letters, it will be 6 factorial. So that means 720. And in the third, all letters are used, but at first it is a vowel. Okay, so here we need a vowel, that means either O or A, and other 5 can be any of them. So that means what? Any of the 2 here into 5 factorial. Okay, any of the 5 you can use here. So that means it will be 2 into, what is 5 factorial? 5 factorial is 4 in, 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So this will be equal to what? It will be equal to 240. So total 240 words can be formed. Okay. Similarly, you can solve the other 2 questions. Those are also easy. So in this way, your exercise 9.3 is completed. And till here we studied our permutation. Okay, next exercise we study combination, and it is the last exercise of this chapter. And after this it is a miscellaneous exercise that also we will solve later classes. Okay, thank you all of you.